Today, we're learning about MRAM memories with Daniela at NVE. So, Dano, what is MRAM?
MRAM stands for Magnetoresistive Random Access Memory. Unlike semiconductor memories that use electron charge to store data, MRAM uses electron spin.
Why is that better?
Unlike charge, electron spin is inherently permanent. MRAM has been called the ideal memory because of its potential to combine the speed of SRAM, the density of DRAM, and the non-volatility of flash.
So how does it work?
Let's look at what's called classical MRAM. Each bit has a spin-dependent tunnel junction memory cell and magnetic row and column write lines. The spin-dependent tunnel junction produces a large change in resistance depending on the predominant electron spin in a storage layer. The tunnel barrier is as thin as a few atomic layers. It's so thin that depending on spin polarizations, electrons can tunnel through the normally insulating material, causing a resistance change. Here's an SEM of an actual MRAM tunnel junction made here at NVE. This white stripe is an aluminum oxide tunnel barrier, 8 atoms thick. This is probably magnified nearly a million times on your screen, so an 8-inch wafer would appear 100 miles in diameter.
We have a separate video explaining tunnel junctions.
So, in MRAM, data is read as the tunnel junction resistance. Data is stored in the spin polarization of a tunnel junction magnetic layer. The write lines produce magnetic fields that store data bits by setting magnetic spin polarization.
So, what's after classical MRAM?
Next generation MRAM could reduce cell size and power consumption. One next generation technology is spin momentum transfer, which changes the spin of storage electrons directly with a spin polarized electrical current rather than an induced magnetic field. This has the potential to significantly reduce MRAM write currents and self-heating.
Thanks, Dano. That was memorable. Go to nve.com for more info on MRAM and spintronics.